What's good with you guys, man? Today I'm going to be showing you guys the best sniping filters here in NBA 2K20 through my team. These new Heatwave packs just dropped, and I want to show you guys the best filters to take advantage of these packs and make millions of MT. So without further ado, let's get straight into it. But actually, first of all, make sure to go ahead and leave a like on this video and subscribe to the channel. I post my team videos every single day, and let's get straight into these filters. There's some really good filters here for these Heatwave packs, so let's get straight into them. So first things first, I'm going to go over here to the name, and I'm going to put it on Ralph Sampson. Ralph Sampson has been one of the most hot filters today by far. And as you can see, Ralph Sampson goes for, he doesn't go for buy now. He goes for over 100K. He is only a little bit over 100K right now. And by the time this video comes out, he might be 100K buy now. So if that's the case, make sure that you just figure out whatever price he's going for. Let's say it's 100K. If he's going for 100K, put the max buy out to 80K and go ahead and snipe like that. But the reason why this filter is so good, even if he's not, or even if he does become a buy now, which it looks like he is about to become a buy now, is because of the fact that people don't realize that this card goes for like almost 100K, and they throw them up for like 10K like all the other ones in this set go for, and you're able to go ahead and snipe them. If you missed my video earlier, I did see one for 45K because of that exact reasoning. People did not realize that. And in my video earlier, when I was literally just showing this filter, I did miss one for 45K just off one refresh. So this is a really good filter. Make sure to go ahead and use it and take advantage of it. But with that being said, let's go ahead and hop into the next filter, which is going to be for another specific player from this set. And it's going to be Klay Thompson. It's a similar thing here with Klay Thompson, where people think he goes for like 10K like all the other ones do. But little do they know that he goes for like 33,000 MT. And by the way, guys, if you do want to see if this card is good, I did drop a video on him earlier, so make sure to go to my channel and check it out. It's actually a pretty solid card, so make sure to go ahead and watch that. But as you can see, he's selling for about 31K instantly. So I would just go over here to this max buyout and put it on about 25K, because you could definitely sell him for 30K instantly, which would be 2K profit after taxes. So if you just put it to 25K here, Klay Thompson, Dark Matter, and keep refreshing, any card you see here is going to be a snipe. And again, I was able to snipe one earlier, not on video or anything, but I did snipe one earlier for 22K. And that's literally just because of the fact that people don't realize or don't think that this card would be going for more than the other ones. But for some reason, it is. It's a pretty solid card, so I guess that's why. But you're able to take advantage of this and get some good snipes off this filter. Make sure to go ahead and use this filter. It's been pretty hot today. But with that being said, let's hop into the next filter, which is going to be the most consistent filter right now and even in the coming days that you can use in my team. The number one most consistent filter in the game right now is going to be for this Dark Matter. Cheapest filter. Now with this filter, be careful to make sure that you know the price of the cheapest Dark Matters before you use a filter like this, because as you can see, it is changing a lot. But it looks like at 7,000 MT, they're selling instantly. Let's move it up a little bit here and see at 7,250. No, so at 7,000 MT, they're selling instantly. I would just put my max buyout on about 5,800, and you're guaranteed profit on every single card that you see on this filter. So literally just Dark Matter, max buyout 5,800. And if you see any of the cheap Dark Matters, just list them up for 7K. And obviously, depending on what card you snipe, check the price of that specific card, because all Dark Matters go for different prices. But even if you do see a cheap one on here, you're still going to profit. And obviously, you have the chance of seeing any Dark Matter on this filter. You can see Invincibles if someone was dumb enough to put one up for 5K. And you're able to literally see anything. I don't know if you guys can hear those sirens, but it sounds like a hospital truck or something is going by my house. But yeah, anyways, guys, I don't care, because I'm sniping cards in my team. But let's go ahead and see what the next filter is going to be today, boys. And that's going to be Galaxy Opal Cheapest. Galaxy Opal Cheapest is very hot on a day like this because of the fact that so many people are shredding open packs and getting Galaxy Opals and just throwing them up for very, very cheap without checking the prices. So as you can see here, it looks like the cheapest Opals are going for 3K. Let me check something actually real quick, because this is something I want to check. How much can you quick sell an Opal for? 2.5K. Okay, so with that being said, just go over to Galaxy Opal, and I would just put the max buyout honestly on like, I would just put it on 2,500 actually. And if you see any Opals showing up on this filter, you can flip them for at least 3,000 MT. But a lot of the Opals are going to be going for more than that. It just depends on which one you do go ahead and snipe. But if you do want to just snipe them and quick sell them, you can literally just put it on 2,000 and then quick sell them. But I would just sell them, because they do sell for a little over 3K. And you can go ahead and do that. But with that being said, let's go ahead and hop into the next filter. What's in my nose right now? Hold up, boys. Ugh, this video is a disaster. Alright, dark matters. No, for dark... Wow. Now, for this dark matter filter, it's not going to be mine out. It's going to be bid sniping. As we saw, the cheapest dark matters are going for about 7,000 MT. So, if you bid about 6,300 on every single dark matter, you actually will profit every time. So, as you can see here, I'm going to go over here and bid 6,300. And again, if I'm able to win any of these for 6,300, I can flip them for 7K and profit every single time. So let's see if that is something that is working right now. As you can see, there is somebody else doing it, which is making it a little bit hard. And this is so loud, bro. Jeez, dude. Outbid, outbid, outbid. But I did win this one with 350 left over. So as you can see, you can simply go ahead and do that and then send it to your auctions and just go ahead and list it up for about 7,000 MT. And that 350 MT that you guys saw left over, that's the profit I make. So I made 350 MT just from simply going ahead and do that for 2 seconds. So if you literally go down the line and do that a million times, you're looking at thousands of MT profit. And honestly, boys, I'm about to go back in here and do it a few more times. So if I just go 6,300, let's go here, 6,300, 6,300. I just want to show you guys exactly how you do this. 6,300 and then 6,300 again. And it's going to start beeping super loud again, bro. Great, great, great. But let's just go here and do another one as well, and then one more just to cap it off at 6,300. And then we just check to make sure real quick that they're still going for about 7K. I want to find the exact number so I know exactly what to list them up for. Are they going for 6,950 or 7? It looks like at 7, they're actually being a little bit slow. But at 6,950, they are instant. And as you can see, I did get outbid every single time there, but I was able to win this one earlier, and I made a couple hundred MT off that. And if you just keep going down the line and doing it over and over and over again, as I did, you will eventually go ahead and win some cards and make thousands of MT. So make sure to go ahead and do that. But if you guys did make it this far into the video, we're going to find the first card that pops into the auction house, and that is going to be the keyword for today's video. So let's see who it is. Okay, no. All right, we're going to do AJ. So if you made it this far into the video, comment the word AJ or AJ Griffin, and I will be liking and replying to every single comment that says AJ or AJ Griffin to see who the loyals are. If you guys don't know, I do this in every video. I do this to see who the loyals are that make it to the end of the video. So I want to see who it is that made it all the way to the end here. And if you did, comment the word AJ, and I will be liking and replying to your comment. But if you guys did enjoy this video, make sure to go ahead and leave a like and subscribe to the channel. I post my team videos every single day. And so, yeah, make sure you have notifications on. You don't want to miss any of my videos. And I hope you guys did enjoy. Go ahead and use these filters and make tons of MT. The auction house is very, very hot right now, so don't miss out on this. And, yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. I'm out of here. Peace out.